to Harry's cocktail adventure. And I've just come back from Spain from a bullfight. And yes, I was in the bullfight. And all I did was run a lot. He did get me once in the back, and I've got to have an operation. But anyway, let's get to what we're talking about. This episode's about things that you would combine that would just be horrible. I'll give an example. For example, honey and Vegemite. Now, I just happen to have some honey and Vegemite here because somebody told me, by the name of John, that he actually eats it and he likes it. So, what this segment is about is some things sound horrible, but they can taste pretty good. So I've never tried this before in my life, so here goes. This is honey and Vegemite for a start, before we get into the drink. Wow, that's not bad. I'm gonna finish that off later, thanks John. Honey and Vegemite, who would have thought? Wow. Okay, the drink, the unthinkable drink, is called Colimocho, which originated in Spain, we think, around the 1970s. And what the story goes that a couple of guys had some cheap red wine, and they thought, can we add something to this? And the other guy said, yeah, I've got some Coke in my bag here. So what he did, he got a glass out, got his wine. Let's experiment. Let's try. This wine is so bad, so cheap. I'll fill it half with wine and half with some Coke. So what I did when I went out yesterday, I even bought cheap Coke. This stuff's only 75 cents. Why waste? Well, I don't drink Coke anyway, but. So yeah, just add that equal parts. So that's wine and Coke. Can you believe it? How disgusting would that be? So what do you think Colimocho means? Well, supposedly it came from a couple of guys in Spanish. I know there must be some translation. Something about geese, young friends circle. I mean, that's all a bit odd to me. Maybe when they were thinking about this, they were looking at geese and they were a close circle of friends. Who knows? But pretty much that's it. Equal parts of the worst wine you can find and some Coke. In fact, I've left this a couple of days so it can oxidise and, if anything, taste a bit better. Now all you had to do is add a bit of ice, which I'll go get back in a sec. La-dee-da. Let's get some ice out. Right, I'll try this again. There we go. Yep. Now just grab some ice. I'm back. Yeah, that bull, he was pretty angry. Just slop that in there. Have a look at that. That is Colimocho. If you look up the spelling of it, there's an X and an O in it, which is pronounced ch, so it's Colimocho in Spain. And when the bull was chasing me, of course I had a glass of this in my hand. Anyway, here goes, see what it's like. I have had this before, actually. Very refreshing. I would actually, I'd use better Coke. That Coles Coke is terrible. But anyway, cheers. Give it a try. It's probably, if you've got some leftover wine and it's a really hot place where you're at, like Spain, in summertime, sit outside and have a go at this. Or, if you're about to confront a bull in a bullfight. But I'd want to drink about 10 of these first. Colimocho, thanks for watching. I'm having some dumplings very shortly. And, yeah. So, I hope you enjoyed the show. Next week, Well, hang on a sec. This is so nice. Vegemite and honey. Not sure what's happening with our next show next week, but stay tuned. I'll get going now. My dumplings are waiting for me.